This is a production of PBS Charlotte.
The baby boom.
Babies all over the map.
The baby boom generation. 76 million Americans born between 1946 and 1964. That's nearly 30% of the U.S. population.
The largest generation in world history.
The first wave of baby boomers started hitting retirement age in the year 2011, and they'll all be there by the end of the next decade. It's no wonder healthcare is always at or near the top of the list of in-demand jobs.
There's a tremendous need for this around the country.
Central Piedmont Community College is well aware of that need. That's why its Health Careers program continues to grow. The college offers programs in everything from biomedical equipment technology to nursing, EMT training, physical therapy, and so on. All taught by experienced and credentialed instructors with plenty of hands-on training.
And we've got state-of-the-art equipment.
The Cardiovascular Technology program is a two-year program. It allows students to choose their own track, invasive or non-invasive.
We say non-invasive, but most people refer to it as cardiac sonography. And invasive, they mostly refer to as cardiac cath or invasive cardiac specialist.
We look at the blood vessels from the inside. So we look for blockages. We help repair and replace cardiac valves. We do all the interior work for the cardiovascular system.
Student Lauren Gully was a high jumper on the UNC Charlotte track team, but while competing, an injury led to a change in her career path.
So I had to have knee surgery from track, and I had to go through physical therapy, and I kind of was leaning towards physical therapy with my exercise science degree. And I was like, I don't want to do this. This is really boring to me.
Around the same time, Lauren's dad had a heart catheterization, which is the insertion of a tube into a chamber or vessel of the heart to help with blood flow.
And I had no idea what it was. And then I kind of was like, oh, wow, that's pretty cool.
So Lauren enrolled in CPCC's program and is set to graduate in May. She's already been offered one job and is interviewing for others.
I definitely feel prepared to be able to do heart caths on people, which I already have been in clinicals for the past year and a half.
Bradford Smith is also set to graduate in May. He's in the non-invasive program.
This is a two-chamber view where we're looking at the left atrium and the left ventricle.
Bradford spent 8 years working in LA as a sound engineer at a recording studio, working alongside some of the biggest names in the music business. He enjoyed it, but the demands of the job became a little too much.
I pretty much accomplished everything that I wanted to accomplish out there. Just working the hours that I was working really didn't leave much time for anything else.
So he came home to Charlotte, enrolling in CP's Cardio Tech program, learning all about the detection and prevention of heart disease using external testing such as ultrasound.
I'm getting to work with sound all over again, just in a completely different way. I feel like I've found the healthcare equivalent of exactly what I was doing before.
So how are we gonna get it out?
You would like for me to cut a smaller piece?
No, we got a big piece. We can't just leave it hanging in the person's body.
Just down the hall, Mel Angela Santi leads first year surgical tech students. A graduate of the program herself, Mel came back to teach and is now the program chair.
I wanted to make a difference. I wanted to help shape the profession. I wanted to help inspire students for something that I am passionate about.
So what exactly is surgical tech?
So everybody likes to compare it to Grey's Anatomy, like, oh, you're the one that hands the knife. It's like, yes, that's part of what we do. They have to know what instruments get used in what parts of the body. They know the anatomy. They know the steps of the surgical procedure just as well as the surgeons do, because their role is to anticipate.
Before students are allowed to graduate, they must first pass their certification exam.
Once they pass that exam, they have a national certification.
So when they graduate, they're fully credentialed to work anywhere in the country.
The median pay for healthcare tech jobs ranges from roughly $38,000 a year for health information techs, $40,000 a year for human services, $45,000 for medical lab, $46,000 for surgical techs, and $58,000 for cardiovascular, with the job outlook in these fields rising faster than most lines of work.
I am consistently seeing $25 an hour, and for a two-year associate's degree, I mean, that's, you know, tremendous.
Our program has 100% successful job placement rate, within 6 months of graduation.
And with that kind of job placement success rate, it's no wonder the program continues to grow. In the fall, the college is launching its polysomnography program.
Polysomnography is the study of sleep medicine, narcolepsy, sleep apnea, periodic limb movement disorder, insomnia, all of those kinds of things.
The world of patient care, it's not just for doctors and nurses anymore. There's a slew of jobs and openings out there. Interested in this field? Charlotte Works can help you map out your career path at no cost. Connect with us at charlotteworks.com/mycareer.
A production of PBS Charlotte.